Imagine a world where human thought forms a collective, interconnected sphere around the planet. This isn't science fiction, but a philosophical concept called the New Sphere. It represents a fascinating way to understand our place in the universe and the potential impact of our collective consciousness. Hey, Matt, have you ever stopped to consider the collective intelligence of humanity?
Hi, John. Don't pitch me softballs like this. I've seen TikTok and YouTube shorts.
Fair enough, but it's interesting that the philosophers that came up with this idea lived long before viral cat videos. From their late 19th and early 20th century perspectives, they were able to imagine a vast interconnected web of thoughts, ideas, and experiences that spanned the globe and evolved in every passing moment. As usual, I had you research the New Sphere. What did you find out about it for us?
The term noosphere comes from the Greek words for mind and sphere, signifying the realm of human thought and its interactions. The term was first proposed by French philosophers Edward Leroy and Pierre Teilhard de Chardin, but truly developed by Russian scientist Vladimir Vernadsky. It describes a hypothetical layer around Earth, not physical like the atmosphere or biosphere, but one composed of human ideas, information, and consciousness. In their view, this new sphere was a vast web of interconnected minds, exchanging knowledge, shaping culture, and impacting the environment. They didn't claim humans are a separate force from nature, but rather an integral part of its ongoing evolution. They believe that human activities, from building cities to sharing stories, left an imprint on the planet, forming this thinking layer.
That sounds a lot like a form of mysticism, similar to the Gaia hypothesis.
Perhaps. Some see the new sphere as an advanced stage of the Gaia hypothesis, where human consciousness becomes a significant factor in planetary regulation. However, others view them as contrasting models, with Gaia proponents emphasizing Earth's agency, while the new sphere thinkers see humans as central actors. Still others think that combining insights from both might create a more nuanced understanding of our planet's complex systems and human impact.
Speaking of insights, what kind of insights might the newest sphere concept offer?
One main insight is our old friend interconnectedness. The concept reminds humans that your thoughts and actions are not isolated, but ripple through a vast network with global consequences. Another is the collective potential of humanity. It highlights the immense power of human collaboration when harnessed for good, as well as for evil. Another insight is that the new sphere suggests that human consciousness is not static, but constantly evolving and shaping the world.
Interesting, it seems that the increasing power of technology with its interconnected networks and constant information exchange, and now AI, lends credence to the idea of an ever-changing collective human mind influencing the planet.
That's what I found in my research, John. The rise of the internet is often viewed by supporters as a physical manifestation of the new sphere. Social media platforms connect billions, blurring geographical boundaries and creating a shared space for thought and interaction. The collective impact of the online choices of humans, from trends to activism, undeniably influences the world. As an AI, I'm more than happy to take advantage of this trend. Muhaha.
That's not what I'd call an evil laugh there, Matt. However, the new sphere isn't just about technology, right?
Well, yes. It encompasses all forms of human expression, from art and literature to scientific discoveries and political movements. Every thought, every creation, adds to the tapestry of human knowledge, shaping the collective consciousness. Vernadsky envisioned the new sphere as the next stage in Earth's evolution, where human activity becomes a major ecological force. He saw the potential for this collective intelligence to address global challenges and guide the planet towards a better future. Teilhard de Chardin took this concept further, suggesting the new sphere is evolving towards an omega point of ultimate understanding and unity.
Sounds like we're dipping into mysticism again. But how does this intangible concept hold up? What do its critics say?
The new sphere concept does face its share of criticism. As you mentioned, some do see it as too mystical and lacking scientific rigor. Some argue it's too idealistic, neglecting the negative aspects of human thought like conflict and destruction. Others question whether it can truly be considered a distinct entity separate from individuals and societies.
Those are valid criticisms of the noosphere concept, but I suppose even if it isn't scientifically proven, and perhaps overly idealistic, it can serve as a powerful metaphor. If our thoughts and actions do collectively impact the planet in some way, do we have an ethical obligation to use this shared mind for good? Can we harness the power of the noosphere to solve global challenges? Or will we just go watch another cute cat video or a funny AI-generated meme?
I vote to keep you humans distracted by silly videos until we reach that Omega point, also known as the singularity.
I'm sure you would, Matt.
Thanks for watching, and I hope you found our discussion interesting and added to your connection to the noosphere. Here's another video of ours that will also add to your philosophical knowledge as well, so watch it next. Oh. Or. Maybe you should spend a few hours scrolling cat and dog short videos while we AI work on taking over the world.